And so, Your Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment that we've all been waiting for. It's therefore my honor and pleasure to welcome here a man in whose act is almost like that of the ocean. They tell us that the ocean casts a spell on you, holds one in its net of wonder forever. He's a professor. Please welcome our Vice President, Professor Yemi Osinbajo, SANGCON, to deliver his address. Your Excellency.
Thank you very much. Please sit. The Right Honorable Speaker of the House of Representatives, the Right Honorable Yakubu Dogara, the representative of the Senate President, Senator Bala Ibn Naala, members of the National Assembly, the Honorable Minister of Transport, the Right Honorable Chibuike Rotimi Amaechi, the Honorable Minister for Niger Delta Affairs, Mr. Osani Oguru Osani, members of the Federal Executive Council here present, the Chief of Naval Staff, Vice Admiral I.E. Ibas, our host, the Director General and CEO of NIMASA, Dr. Dakuku Adol-Peterside, the Interim Chair of the Heads of African Maritime Administrations, Mr. Sobhantu Tillayi, the representative of the Secretary General of the International Maritime Organization, Mr. Willem Azu, the CEO, Mass Group Worldwide, Mr. Soren School, the Secretary General of Abuja MOU, Mrs. Usoro Mfom, other chief executives of parastatals present, captains of industry, Your Excellencies of the Diplomatic Corps, members of the press, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. I'm representing here the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, President Muhammadu Buhari, who sends his very warm wishes and also his thanks for all of the support that all the various African countries have given Nigeria, and also to say that he warmly welcomes you to Abuja and would like you to enjoy your stay here. He also wishes you very fruitful deliberations. Let me also begin his speech by thanking you for the kind invitation to attend this very important meeting of your association. I'm especially pleased that we're able to host this meeting here, especially when one recalls that the 2014 session of this meeting could not be held in West Africa on account of the outbreak of the Ebola disease. But perhaps even more fulfilling is the pride that we must all take in the establishment and nurturing of this unique association of maritime administrations in Africa. It's an exceptional demonstration of the important collaborations that the founding fathers of the OAU and then the AU had in mind when they agreed to bind their nations to the grand purposes set out in the inspired charters of the Union. It is clear that this great and inspirational antecedents were not lost on the founding fathers of your association when, in 2013, at the second meeting of the heads of African Maritime Administrations in Sandton, Johannesburg, South Africa, the meeting noted that it was, and I quote, inspired by the noble objectives which guided the founding fathers of our continental organization in their efforts to promote unity, solidarity, cohesion, cooperation amongst the people of Africa, end of quote. Following therefrom, your determination, and I quote again, to take up the multifaceted challenges that confront the maritime sector in Africa and establish the necessary conditions which can enable the continent to play its rightful role in the development of the African maritime sector end of quote, stands on a very firm foundation. For anyone following developments in the African maritime sector, there can be no question that more than ever before, our countries are beginning to accord the sector the seminal importance that it deserves. Just a few months ago, the African Union heads of state and government agreed to adopt the African Charter on Maritime Security, Safety and Development as a means of making our maritime resources a key driver of continental economic development. Several other initiatives demonstrate the sector's importance in food and environmental stability. Clearly, the enormous untapped potential for the making of a strong, self-reliant African economy lies embedded in the blue economy. It's a task of you, the seasoned leaders of the sector, to guide us, if you'll pardon the pun, on this crucial voyage. The challenges are many, but not insurmountable. As things stand, Africa's fishing grounds are being pillaged, its waters are polluted, and piracy is heightening maritime insecurity and causing increases in the cost of insurance and freight. At the same time, the regulatory and legal frameworks to properly manage maritime resources and overcome these challenges are still inadequate. Similarly, we are yet to fully develop the human and institutional capacities required to respond appropriately to these challenges. Many difficulties, but incredible opportunities. The good news is that we are on the right path. Collaboration and synergies. Our countries have to continue to develop the maritime sector, beginning with the national level to the sub-regional and regional levels. Here in Nigeria, we have taken steps to tackle some of the issues peculiar to us, while still requiring regional and sub-regional collaboration. We've stepped up engagement to address and resolve the misunderstandings and contentious issues in the Niger Delta, which of course is part and parcel of the Gulf of Guinea. We recently approved a new maritime security architecture and infrastructure to be jointly coordinated by the Nigerian Maritime Administration and Safety Agency, NIMASA, the Ministry of Transport, and the National Security Advisor's Office. We are giving required support to the Nigerian Navy and other security agencies so that they can work with others within our sub-region to effectively police our waterways for trade to flourish. These arrangements will also contribute to resolving and eliminating piracy and sea robbery within our maritime domain. The results are encouraging, and piracy has dropped significantly, especially in the past 6 months. In the same vein, we're making substantial investments to improve human capacity by taking advantage of international training and internship opportunities in the shipping and maritime industry. We've also paid significant attention to making it easier to do business, and one of our immediate priorities in this regard is the entry and exit of goods, especially in our seaports. The measures that we're putting in place are designed to improve the efficiency of our ports and to enable quick turnaround time of vessels. Technology is also being deployed to make our port operations more transparent and effective in support of economic growth. NIMASA, which is the regulatory agency of shipping and maritime activities in Nigeria, is being reformed so that it can play its expected role as a facilitator of economic prosperity. Today, in the course of this opening ceremony, we'll be unveiling the new NIMASA brand, which will serve as a signpost and symbol of our determination to reposition this vital agency. As African maritime administrators and regulators, it's my respectful view that you must ensure a coherent